shall we please be seated. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We have electrified the heavens. It is time to hear the last word from the Papa of this seminary. And with a standing ovation, let us all be on our feet as we welcome the president of the seminary, Reverend Dr. Frederick Trevor, to give us his last verses.
Let's give a shout to the Lord. Some people came to Jerusalem. A vast army is coming against you from Edom, from the other side of the Dead Sea. It is already in Hazazon town. Alarmed, Jehoshaphat resolved to inquire of the Lord, and he proclaimed a fast for all Judah. The people of Judah came together to seek help from the Lord. Indeed, they came from every town in Judah to seek him. Then Jehoshaphat stood up in the assembly of Judah and Jerusalem, the temple of the Lord, in front of the new courtyard, and said, this is his prayer. Lord God of our ancestors, are you not the God who is in heaven? You rule over all the kingdoms of the nations. Power and might are in your hand. No one can withstand you. Our God, did you not drive out the inhabitants of this land before your people Israel? Give it to you. Give it forever to the descendants of Abraham, your friend. They have lived in it and have built it in a sanctuary for your name, saying, now he is reminding God of the promise he has made. If calamity comes upon us, whether the sword of judgment or plague or famine, we will stand in your presence before this temple that bears your name, and will cry out to you in our distress, and you will hear us and save us. So, Jehoshaphat stood up based on the promise of God. He prayed. But let's see the outcome of the prayer. 14. Then the Spirit of the Lord came on Ahaziel, son of Ariah, the son of Benaniah, the son of Jehiel, the son of Mattaniah, the Levite, and he said, son of Asa, as he stood in the assembly. He said, listen, King Jehoshaphat, and all who live in Judah and Jerusalem, this is what the Lord says to you. Do not be afraid of this camp because of this vast army, but the battle is not yours, but God's. Yeah. Tomorrow, march down against them. They will be climbing up the pass of Ziz, and you will find them at the feet of the God in the desert of Jehu. You will not have to fight this fight. Take up your position, stand firm. See the deliverance the Lord will give you. Judah and Jerusalem, do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. Go out to face them tomorrow, and the Lord will be with you. Amen. The Lord is here. You see, prayer, God responded to the prayer, and prayer brought direction. It didn't bring deliverance. The prayer told them what they should do. You don't have to fight. If you don't have to fight, and God has to fight for you, what do you do? After this, you see the king drawing a strategy. Soldiers leading the battle. He sent the soldiers back, appointed singers to lead in the war. Why did the king do that? Why should he send the army backwards and then the choir without any ammunition in front of me. Policeman, it's a Ramoko. He did that because God had told them they don't have to fight. He's already told them the battle is not for the army. So God, how are you going to fight? You see, God, you don't have to fight because it is not a physical warfare. God is going to do the fight. So we need the sinners, the choir, you need. Ladies and gentlemen, if we want God to fight for us, we need a strategy, grace. We need to release strategy. It's not that what is strategic grace. You see, at this time, they're not going to fail the army. They still take a plan. Then the king came out with a plan. This is the strategy. You sing in advance. Correct. When I see the anchor, you begin to sing. Ah, it looks like you are sleeping. And that's what you find difficult to do. Yeah. You know what? ISIS, Boko Haram.
Because he loves you.
Amen. Oh, amen is real. See, some of us think that God hates us. So you can say you fear be falling down. It's all lies. We say God loves you. Instead of complaining about your family and these enemies and that, sing to Him in advance. Praise Him in advance. Thank Him in advance. Thank His love in advance. His love is not short-lived. You cannot exhaust the love that God has for you.
You cannot exhaust it.
You can't. Not even your sin will prevent God from loving you. Praise and thank you because He loves you. You see, I keep saying that God so loves us that and ready to share everything with us to the extent that He even wants to share His blood with you. Wants to share Nimoja represent. It's because so when releasing Nimoja, you will die and go to hell. He's ready to release it for your freedom,
amen.
For your cleansing,
amen.
For your upkeep,
amen.
And for eternity. Say, what you put on your mind?
A dear view.
What else will he meet? Amen. So, whether gang up army, gang up devils, gang up human beings, we will still sing in advance, praise Him in advance, thank Him in advance. Then the scripture says, all yes, I do in the all my kind, and I can. I see. Now listen, verse 22. As they began to sing, are you there? And praise. The Lord sets ambush against the men of Ammon and Moab. Thank God after He's done something for you, you're only showing your gratitude. But if you thank Him in advance, sing to Him in advance, praise Him in advance, praise His love in advance before He does the thing for you, then you are showing your faith in Him. You're telling Him that, Lord, I believe, I have confidence in you. Because you love me. If you send your mind back to God, see what He did for you. Now, see, some of us are thinking it's too small. What we want are the cities and the papers and the monies and the things. But God has higher plans for you. Eternal plan. He has them for you. Then the Ammonites and Moabites rose up against the men from the Mount Seir to destroy and annihilate them. After they finished throttling the men from Seir, they helped to destroy one another. You don't have to fight. If you want God to fight for you, learn to sing to Him in advance. Learn to praise him in advance. Learn to thank him in advance. That is strategic praise. So this morning, we're going to be strategic in our praise. About 8. How many minutes? 10 minutes. Somebody says 20. We're going to thank God. You see, we are crying for hostel, whatever. We're going to sing to him in advance of those days. We're going to praise him in advance of those days. We're going to thank him in advance. And then, after doing all these and the things we're expecting in this school, after we praise him for that, then you sing, you praise, you thank him in advance of the mountains that are so high that you can climb in your life. And the enemies that are in your life, we're going to thank them, we're going to thank God in advance so that he himself will begin to destroy the enemies for us. How many of us can face this vast army? None of us. But God can. He is able to do exceedingly abundantly beyond what we ask or even think. Are there strategic singers here? Yeah. Come and sing, come and sing.